प्रतिबोधितां भगवतां नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन प्रदितां पुराणमुनीनां मध्ये महाभारतम्।
The fifth chapter, Karma Sanyasa Yoga. Starts with Arjuna's question. Arjuna Uvacha Sanyasam Karmanam Krishna Punaryoganjasamsasi यस्येयेतयोरेकं दन्मे ब्रूहि सुनिश्चितम्। अर्जुन सेड, ओ कृष्णा, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू आस्क मी टू अनाउंस वर्क एंड देन अगेन यू रेकमेंड वर्क विद डिवोशन। नाउ विल यू काइंडली टेल मी डेफिनेटली विच ऑफ द टू इज मोर बेनिफिशियल। I really feel Arjuna must be playing a game. A person who was a king can never be so dumb. Again and again, Krishna is explaining so clearly in every sloka, but Arjuna is coming back to the same point. Either both of them are playing a game so that the Gita can be delivered to the world, or there is no way Arjuna can be saved. There is no other book which is so clear, so direct. There is no other master who is so straight giving instructions. Again, Arjuna asks, O Krishna, first of all you ask me to renounce work, and then again you recommend work with devotion. Now will you kindly tell me definitely which of the two is more beneficial? You will never be able to solve the problem if you start thinking which will be more beneficial. Please be very clear, you can never solve a problem if you start thinking which will be more beneficial. Before thinking which will be more beneficial, you should be clear of one point: with what scale you want to measure your benefits. That's a basic thing. What is the scale you are going to use to measure whether you are benefited or not, whether you are successful or not? Before thinking whether you are successful or not, before coming to the conclusion whether you are successful or not, you need to know with which scale you are going to measure your life. Before that, unless you know the scale with which you are going to measure your life, you can't jump to conclusion. Jumping to the conclusion should be done with clear intelligence. Small one-liner. What do you call falling out of an airplane without parachute? That is jumping to the conclusion. Jumping to a conclusion. If you do it without a proper scale, you are just jumping to a conclusion. You don't know where you are landing. Before understanding, before measuring your life, whether you are successful or not, you should be clear with what scale you are going to measure your life. In the end of the day, if you are going to measure your life with the scale of dollars, then you have to work only for dollars. In the end of the day, you know with which scale you are going to measure your life. So from morning till evening, you will work only for that goal. End of the day, you know, yes, this is the scale with which I am going to measure my life. You can come to a conclusion whether you are successful or failure. But by the time you reach the evening, the very scale changes. Then what to do? In our life, when we start our life, the scale is different. When we end our life, the scale with which we are measuring whether we are successful or failure, the very scale changes. I can tell one thing, fortunately the scale changes. Only for a matured person scale changes. If you learn the lessons from existence, if you learn the lesson from life, the scale with which you will measure your life, whether you are successful or not, should change. If it does not change, please be very clear, you are going to take one more life from zero. Where you left, you are going to start your life from the same point. Unless you learn the lesson, you are not going to end the game. You are going to play the same game again and again and again. If the scale changes, the scale with which you measure whether you are successful or not, if it changes, it shows you are getting mature. If it stays in the same scale, dollar, if it stays in the same scale, money, please be very clear, not only you will not be able to measure your life clearly, second thing, you will be sure failure, third thing, you will again start your whole game from day one. From day one, how you came to the planet Earth, with the same maturity, you will start your next life also. In all three ways, you will be a failure. A man whose scale has not become mature is a very important thing. If only dollar is your scale, if only outer world comfort is your scale, be very clear, again and again you will feel you could have done little more. You could have done little more. I could have done little more. I think I missed. Let me tell you a small story. One barber, King's barber. That guy used to live a very happy life. Every day morning, he will go and shave King's face. King will give 10 coins. He will come back to the house. He will live his life happily with the 10 gold coins. Next day, he will again go, shave the barber's face, shave the King's face, come back, have his 10 coins salary, live his life. His life was really beautiful, blissful. Nothing to bother about. There is nothing about which he is worried. He was happy. One day, when he was coming back from King's Palace, suddenly he heard a voice. He heard a voice. Booming voice. Dear son, do you want pot filled with gold coins? This man said, pot filled with gold coins. But what am I going to do? I have no use for that. My expense is $10 and that is enough. My expense is just 10 gold coin. That is enough. I don't need anything more. The booming voice says, all right, I'll give you 24 hours to think. You can go to your house. You can discuss with your wife. Come back tomorrow and tell me. This poor guy, he could have at least kept quiet. He went and opened his mouth to his wife. Now you know. You fool, don't you have sense? You should have brought that jar. And you never did this for me, you never did that for me. Throughout my life, I am wearing the same sari. You have never given me any jewelry. You never got this for me. You never took me here. You never took me there. What did I enjoy after marrying you? I always tell, marriage is three ring circus. One is engagement ring. Next is wedding ring. Third is suffering. Engagement ring, wedding ring, and suffering. She starts shouting at him. This guy says, all right, don't worry. The booming voice has given me time. Till tomorrow morning, I have time to decide. Next day morning, I'll talk to him and get the pot. He goes there, Next day morning, he asked that voice, "Please give me that jar." Immediately, Yaksha is appearing there. Yaksha means a man who has got wealth but who never enjoyed. Who has got wealth but who never enjoyed. In India, there will be a lot of this. Agriculture fields. They will keep 2-3 dogs. The dogs, neither they will eat, nor they will allow other animals to come and eat. Same way, if you have wealth, neither you enjoy, nor you share with others. You are called Yaksha. Yaksha is a person who has got wealth. Neither he enjoys, nor he shares with the world. I always tell people, either you do dana or you become Mahadana. If you do dana, a little bit you will share and you will also enjoy. Others also enjoy. If you don't do small danas, you will become Mahadani. Means you will leave everything and go away. Once for all. Yaksha is a person who has got enough wealth, but he never enjoys and never shares with others. Somehow he appears and he says, "Have this jar. This jar has got 990 gold coins. Just 10 gold coins less. Just 10 gold coins less." The guy brought the gold jar back to the house. He is very happy that he can spend it for at least 990 days. He can be happy. He spends $10 at least 99 days he can spend. The moment wife got the jar, she said, "What is this? The jar is not over. The jar is not overflowing. There is something missing." He said, "I don't know. This is the way I got the jar. The Yaksha told me it is a little less." She started worrying. If it is full, overflowing, how nice it will be. It would have been so nice. Anyhow, next day, the barber comes back. She takes all the gold coins and puts it in that jar. She wants the jar to overflow. Again, the jar is little low. It is not full, because Yaksha's jar never gets filled. Yaksha's jar means your mind. Your mind is Yaksha's jar. Yaksha's jar is made of our kapala, our head. However you may have, whatever you may get, in 10 days you will feel it is not sufficient. In 10 days your mind will take everything for granted. Raman Maharshi says beautifully, before achieving, even a mustard seed will look like a mountain. Without that, as if your life will not move. That's a basic important thing for your life. Once you achieve it, even a mountain will look like a mustard seed. The mind is such, before achieving, even a mustard seed will look like a mountain. Once you achieve, even a mountain will look like a mustard seed. She feels there is something missing. Next day again, she takes the money from barber and puts it in the jar. Again, it is little low. It's almost, but it is not full. Continuously, 1 week, she is not giving food for barber. She is not doing anything to him. She takes away all the money and she wants only one thing, that jar should overflow. By 1 week, this fellow has become tired, dull. His face has become very dull. King started inquiring, what happened? You used to look so fresh. What happened to you? For last 1 week, you are tired. And you started thinking about something. You started worrying. What happened to you? Did you accept Yaksha's jar? King asks him, did you accept any gold pot from anybody? Suddenly, Barber is just shocked. He says, oh king, how do you know? King says, whomsoever is suffering in this country, whomsoever is unhappy in this country, all of them have accepted Yaksha's jar. Please be very clear. Go back to your house and see, do you have a Yaksha's jar or not? If you are worrying, if you are suffering, there is every chance in your house you are having Yaksha's jar. If you have Yaksha's jar, of course, when I say Yaksha's jar, it may not be there in your house, it will be there in your head. Yaksha's jar is made out of kapala, means the head, which always makes you feel you are not enough, you are not complete, you are not full. The head which makes you think continuously you are not enough, you are not complete, is what is Yaksha's jar. When you go back to your house, check once, do you have Yaksha's jar in your house? Be very clear. Sometime Yaksha's hand over the jar in the form of bank balance. Don't think you may have just a bar. You may have just a jar. Don't think it will be just only in the form of a jar. It may be in your mind. Man who is continuously feeling that he is not fulfilled, or man who is measuring his whole life with the scale of wealth, will never feel fulfilled. Because he has got Yaksha's jar in his house, he will have only more and more suffering. Yaksha's jar will never be fulfilled. Yaksha's jar will never be filled. First, we need to understand with what scale you are going to measure your life, whether your life is beneficial or not. That itself has to be defined. Only then you can enter, you can choose the path. The end of the day, end of your life, at the end of your life, how you are going to measure your life, that whether it was successful or not. Now itself, let you be very clear. What is the scale? Here Arjuna asks, sanyasam karmanam krishna punar yoganja samsasi yasreya yedayo regam danme bruhi sunischitam. Now will you kindly tell me definitely which of the two, karma or sannyasa, which of the two is more beneficial? We are all again and again asking this question to ourselves. Man is dilemma. Please be very clear. Your mind is nothing but dilemma. Your mind will be alive as long as you are caught between the extremes. The moment you come to any single conclusion, you will be liberated. The moment you reach any conclusion, you will be liberated. You will be ignorant as long as you are moving from this extreme to that extreme. Don't say ignorance is bliss. If ignorance is bliss, why so many people are suffering in the planet Earth? Why do you think so many are suffering? Ignorance is not bliss. Innocence is bliss. That is different. Innocence means you will not carry a scale with which continuously you will be measuring your life. Ignorance means you will have a scale, but you are not able to fulfill your life according to your scale. If you neither have scale nor have a goal, then no problem. But here, you have intelligence, you have intellect, you have enough of intellect to have a scale, but you are not able to fulfill it. That is what I call ignorance. First thing we need to understand is man as such is a disease. The first and last disease is dilemma. Dilemma is the disease with which he starts his life and ends his life. I can't even say ends. He will be in a dilemma whether to end or not. It is just taken away from him. It is just taken away from him. Why do you think worry kills more people than work? Because more people worry than work. Worry is nothing but dilemma. Here, Arjuna is having a dilemma, which is more beneficial for me. If you look into the whole life as a utility, some way of benefit, please be very clear, you are creating, you are building your own hell. Life has no separate benefit. Life itself is benefit. You cannot measure your life, whether it is success or failure, with a scale. If you have a scale, please be very clear. If you don't achieve, you will feel life is a failure. If you achieve, you will face the depression of success. That's all. Both the way, you are going to be in trouble. Life itself is a benefit. If you ask which of the two is more beneficial, that also more beneficial. Business mind, a pure business mind, with the life you cannot do business. Whole life cannot be business. Be very clear. At some point, you need to relax from business. You need to relax from the business mentality. I always tell people, at least half an hour per day, at least 30 minutes per day, do something which will not get dollars for you. Some painting, some writing, some poetry. When you start painting yourself, don't start thinking of a big gallery. I'll make all these paintings and put gallery in New York and make money. When you start writing few poems, don't start thinking of Nobel Prize. I'll publish this and it will become like Gitanjali, then I will have Nobel Prize. No. Without thinking about any result, benefit, just do something. Go to a place like this, some temple, clean it, wipe it. Don't think, I'll become leader of volunteer batch. The moment you take a broomstick in your hand, start mopping, start cleaning the room, start cleaning the temple, you start planning how to have a volunteer batch and how to become leader of that batch. All you need to do is only one thing, a simple technique. The whole thing is now reduced to one line message. Let all your mental thoughts, let all your physical deeds be directed towards the gratitude to the divine. Don't work out of fear or greed. Because whatever you achieve out of your greed, you are not going to feel fulfilled. It's like pouring ghee into the fire. Can you quench the fire by pouring ghee into it? Never. So you will never be able to feel the fulfillment. So all your actions done out of greed will only make your senses weak and tired. Same day, all your laziness done out of fear will only make your mind restless. Because you may not do anything physically, but your mind will be worrying. If you have become karma yogi out of greed, your senses will be only weakened, because how much you will run, all the running will make only your senses weak. If you become sannyasi out of fear, again, you may not do anything physically, but whole day will be sitting and worrying. A small story, one-liner. When a man don't have money, the problem is money. When he has got money, the problem is sex. When he has got sex, the problem is comforts. When he has got comforts, when everything goes well, he starts worrying about the death. He has started bothering about the death. He has started thinking about death. Something or other will be going on in your mind. Don't think people who have become sannyasis, who are sitting in the Himalayas, they are in the bliss. They are in ecstasy. No. Unless they change the attitude, they cannot experience joy. Unless the attitude changes, they cannot experience bliss. Bliss is directly related to your attitude. Being, doing, and having. Your whole life will be directed to doing and having if you are caught in fear and greed. If you center yourself into the being, doing and having, both will happen through you with a tremendous ecstasy. Never work out of greed, because that is waste. Never work out of fear. Again, it is waste. Never become silent out of fear, because there is nothing to lose. Never become silent out of fear, because why should you be afraid? Whether you are afraid or not, everything is going to be taken away. Why not be blissful? Same way, never work out of greed, because whatever you achieve is going to be taken away. Then why should you waste your life in working? Both the corners. Understand, there is a beautiful story. One man goes to Ramakrishna and asks for money as a blessing. Ramakrishna will never bless for money. He will never bless for money. He goes to Ramakrishna and asks, Master, please bless me. I should have wealth. Finally, Ramakrishna says, all right, let you have wealth. You will be surprised. He was working. He was not working. Actually, he used to collect paper from road. The roadside, he will collect the papers. And he will go to house and collect the old paper. And make money out of it. He used to make his living out of it. The day Ramakrishna blessed, something happened. Within 10 years, he became the owner of a very big magazine called Ananda Bazar Patrika. If you are from Calcutta, you know. The founder of Ananda Bazar Patrika is disciple of Ramakrishna. Ramakrishna blessed him, you will have wealth. Till today, the magazine is running. And you will be surprised. You don't have kids. You don't have kids. In the end of the life, he says, oh God, now I realize I asked for wealth from Master. Now I understand. Throughout my life, I did only one thing. I work like a donkey, that's all, nothing else. I created the whole thing and I am now leaving it and going away. I just work for somebody who is going to enjoy this wealth. So if you work out of greed, please be very clear, one day you will repent. One day you will repent. Why do you think parents are so possessive of children? Because they have vengeance inside. I worked, created so much wealth, I am leaving it for you. Why don't you fellow obey from my words? Listen to my words. All the possessiveness comes because you suffered and created the wealth. That is why you have so much of possessiveness. You try to control them so much. If the wealth is created without suffering, when you give also, it will be like a graceful. You will give gracefully as a gift. You will not bind him in so many ways. You will not torture him. You will not expect him to do so many things. You will not play with your wealth. You will clearly write will in an open way. Why do you think people write always their will secretly? Why do you think people write their will secretly? So that they will be dangling the carrot. It is nothing but dangling the carrot. The guy should be continuously behind them. The person who has created wealth out of suffering, when he gives the wealth, he will share, he will give the suffering also. People come and ask me, Swamiji, I hear that father's parents' karma will come to the son. Children, is it true? Surely the sins and merits of the parents will not come to you, but the mental setup will come to you. Because they will try to force that on you. They will try to force that mental setup on you. They will expect that you should live as they want. They will try. We always try to fulfill our ambitions through our kids. If you want to become doctor, if you have not achieved, if you have not become doctor, you try to fulfill your ambition through your kids. You try to fulfill your ambitions through the next generation. Never do that. If you do that, you will be destroying their life. You will be sharing not only your wealth, your suffering also. The man who created the wealth out of suffering will give suffering to the person to whom he gives the wealth. And next thing, if he is not able to torture the son or the daughter who is receiving the wealth, he will start suffering. If he knows, this fellow is not going to listen to me, he is not going to live as I want, he will start suffering. And leaving all these things, believing him, I don't know what will happen, I don't know what he will do. When he dies, he will have worst death. He will be like a yaksha. He will come back and sit on the property. Be very clear. He will not let even his son to enjoy the property. He will come back and sit on the property. I have seen many litigation cases. The parents, when they give their wealth to kids, somehow or other, even after 30, 40 years, the kids will not be able to enjoy the wealth. Be very clear, it means the property is with Yaksha. The guy has come back and he is sitting as Yaksha in the property. Neither he will enjoy nor he will allow others to enjoy. If the property will be in Indian litigation, Indian court. In Indian courts, you know, when judgments come. The last judgment day. Only on that day all the judgments are given. And when the last judgment day, neither you know nor I know. I don't know whether God knows or not. There's a small story. American president goes to God and asks, God, when our country will become number one. God says 50 years. Then he thinks, array 50 years, I don't know whether I will be alive or not. He starts weeping. Next, Russian president goes and asks God, God, when will our country become first? He says 100 years. Oh, neither I will be alive nor my son will be alive. He starts weeping. Indian chief, he goes and asks God, God, when will India become chief? God starts weeping. I don't know whether I will be alive or not. Till that time, I don't know whether I will be alive or not. So be very clear. Whenever the judgment comes, it takes its own sweet time. For a file to move from one table to another table, if file grows the leg and moves by itself, only then it is possible. Otherwise, it takes its own sweet time. What to do? Truth has to be told, nothing else can be done. We have to share the truth. It means the yaksha is sitting. Again and again, we share what we create. That's what I always tell people. If the wealth is created out of pain body, you will transfer the pain body also to the next generation along with the wealth. If it is created out of just relaxed mood, out of voluntary decision, or I can say without any strong motivation. One important thing we should understand, working without motivation is completely unheard in the West. All the people who are working in the field of mind, psychologists, psychiatrists, the people who work, do research in the field of mind, all the scientists always emphasize, without motivation you cannot work. That is why so many motivational gurus in the West. West is haunted by motivational gurus. So many motivational gurus. Please be very clear, these scientists, these psychologists, these doctors have come to the conclusion after doing analysis on patients, not on an enlightened man. They never had a specimen of a Buddha. They never encountered an enlightened man. That is the reason they say work without motivation is impossible. I tell you, work without motivation is the only work. Work without motivation will never make you tired. Will never make you tired. Every moment you will be ecstatic. You will be working out of bliss. If you can understand this one concept, this one technique, further he explains, Krishna explains. And first time Krishna gives a meditation technique in this chapter. Today we will practice that technique to achieve the bliss consciousness. Till the fifth chapter, he is giving only intellectual advice, Shastra. Now he thinks whether Arjuna is matured or without technique, it is now impossible to relate with him. He has come to some conclusion. Either Arjuna is matured or if I don't give technique, I cannot escape from him. Masters give meditation techniques in two different persons. One is when he sees a person is matured enough. Another one is better let us give some technique, otherwise he will eat our head. He will continue to question. He will not keep quiet. So here, I don't know why Krishna has decided. Whether he thought the Arjuna has become matured or he thinks let him at least sit few minutes with closed eyes. He is giving a technique. Now we will practice, we will enter into the technique in the next session. Before the technique, he gives a beautiful explanation about the technique and he gives the technique.